guys, Finn. I'm back with another review. This time it's the Canon 8-15mm. I'll roll some footage for you guys and then let me know what you think after. So that was the Canon 8-15mm test footage that I did last night. It was a little weird filming back with my HD camera since I've been using the VX for so long. Obviously it doesn't have any LCD screen, so it took a little bit of getting used to film back with my HD camera, but I think I got some good clips. Anyways, I'm actually filming with the 8-15mm right now, and as you can tell, it just looks so sharp. Compared to the Optica fisheye lens, I was looking back at that footage, and it almost looks kind of cloudy compared to this footage, just because the lens quality is so vastly different. The natural vignetting on the sides kind of reminded me of the look you get from one of the extreme fisheye lenses, which costs like $4,000. One thing that actually kind of bothers me though is that you can't film all the way 8mm with this lens hood on, or else it actually gets in the frame. One more thing about the lens hood is that I've actually seen people complaining that the cap that fits on top of it falls off. I don't see any problem with mine. I've never had it like fall off, or it doesn't even really jiggle around. It just kind of just pops on and then pops off. It's really easy and it seems to be working fine. One thing to keep in mind when you're watching the clips is that this is a fisheye lens, doesn't have image stabilization. Also, I'm shooting on my 80D, which doesn't have in-camera image stabilization. So if you did have a camera that has a built-in image stabilization, you probably could get a lot smoother look with this, but I was just filming this without any image stabilization at all, besides my cam caddy to kind of stabilize it, but that's about it. Let's move on to talk about the autofocus from the lens. Now obviously, if you have a different camera, the autofocus will act differently, but with my 80D, it performed better than most other lenses I've had, including Canon lenses. While the autofocus was really fast and smooth, unfortunately, it is a little bit noisy, but if you're using this primarily for skateboard filming, then you probably are always in manual focus because you already have it locked in. Even if you are using an autofocus mode and it does make a little bit of sound, probably won't be able to hear it in the recording of the video. As for the focus ring, it's super smooth, just like it should be from an L series lens. The 8-15 also has a limiter switch, which will make it a 10-15mm lens, but that's really only useful if you're on a full frame camera, so you don't have the completely circle look. You'll have what you find from a crop sensor camera, which is just the vignetting on the edges. One more feature about this camera and why it makes it just so many steps ahead of something like the Optica lens is that when you can actually focus on objects super close, like look at that, this is like half an inch from the lens and it still focuses on it. So unlike the Optica, where if you put it like within a few inches it wouldn't, like it couldn't even get the focus from that range, this 8-15 does a really good job with that. Looking to get this lens and you only have a crop sensor camera, and that's the reason why you're not getting it, don't worry, because it works on both crop sensor cameras and full frame cameras, and it will still improve the look of your beginner to intermediate camera and not just your pro cameras. One thing I noticed when I was playing the video back is there is some chromatic aberration happening in the sides of the video, but it's really hard to tell, especially if you're only watching it on your phone or something like that. And I'm pretty sure there are some plugins that can just clean up all that noise and stuff like that, so I would look into that, but I wouldn't be too worried about it. So some of the biggest pros for me from this lens is that it has a really clear image, it has a natural vignetting on the corners, and also it has a really close focusing distance, which will come in handy. And there are only two cons I can think of. One is that the lens hood doesn't work when you're in 8mm because it shows on the sides. A lens hood is honestly really important when you're filming skateboarding because it adds a little bit of extra protection, and also it obviously helps block the light if you're in harsh shooting conditions. And the only other con I could think of was the chromatic aberration happening in the sides of the screen, but again, it's not a huge deal, and I might even try to look for some sort of plugin to help fix that. If you guys are looking to purchase this lens, I can leave a link in the description. It is a really expensive lens, but it'll go with you everywhere since it can go from crop sensors to full frames, so if you ever want to update your camera, this lens can always go with you. You don't have to sell this and buy something new. Anyways, make sure to drop a sub, and I'll see you guys in the next video.